Now, speed, time and distance. Before moving, we should know what is speed. Later on, I will explain what is time and what is distance. Say for example, like we go to any place, for example, we are going to market. We ask the driver to speed up, right? That is the time when we are using the word speed. So, what is actually speed? Distance covered by object in unit time. Please pay attention to these two words that I've highlighted, that is distance and time. So, distance covered by object in unit time. What do you mean by unit over here? Unit means one. That means it could be 1 second, 1 minute, 1 hour and so on. So, that means the distance covered by any object in unit time is referred to as my speed. Now, speed is measured in these units, kilometer per hour or meter per second. Now, how these units are derived, that also I am going to tell you. First of all, based on the definition, let us derive the formula of speed. The formula for speed would be, as it says, distance covered, right? So, we will write the distance covered by object in unit time. So, that means you can say distance traveled per unit time. This is the formula for speed. Now, according to this formula, if distance is given in kilometers, what is the SI unit of distance? Or what I mean to say, the SI unit of distance would be as kilometers, right? And what is the SI unit of time? That is seconds. Now, when you are writing the speed, you have to write the speed only in two units, that is either kilometer per hour. That means either your distance will be in kilometers and time will be in hours, or what can take place, or your distance can be measured in meters and your time can be measured in seconds. So, when the distance is in kilometers and time is in hours, your speed will come out to be in the units of kilometer per hour. But if the distance is given in meters and time is in seconds, the speed will be measured in meter per seconds. Now, these are the two units in which speed is measured. Now, from this, can we derive the formula for time? Sometimes what happens is, you have to calculate the speed. You are given the distance and you are given the time. When you are given the distance, you are given the time, you can find out the speed. Sometimes what happens is, you might have to calculate the time taken by an object. Okay, if I ask you how much time will you take to travel from your home to school if your speed is 50 kilometers per hour. Like that is the question in which the speed is given, the distance is also given, but you need to find out the time. So, for time calculation, we will be using this formula only. Only difference is that we are going to change its representation. How is that representation changed? Okay, we need to find out time. First of all, let us make this expression a bit simpler one. Okay, if you multiply speed and time, why I am multiplying these both? Because here my time was in denominator. If I want to transpose it to the other side of the equal to sign, that means it will get multiplied, as we know. So, the speed into time will be equal to distance. Now, here by doing this, we have got the formula for distance. You can see if the speed is given to you and time is given to you, you can calculate the distance very easily. Now, this was for distance. Now, let us move on and calculate the formula, or let us derive the formula for time. Now, from here, we can conclude that time would be equal to this distance over speed. How did I conclude this? Because over here, the speed was getting multiplied with time. So, when I transpose it to the other side, it will get divided. So, we get the formula for time as time is equal to distance upon speed. Now, these are the three basic formulas for this chapter. They will be used in this chapter, right, repeatedly. So, you should be aware of all the three. This is for the calculation of speed. This is for the calculation of distance. And this is for the calculation of time. Now, as I discussed the units for measurement of speed, it is kilometer per hours and meters per second. These are the two units of measurement of speed. Now, similarly, we have units of measurement of distance also. What are those units? Distance can be measured either in kilometers or meters, and so many other units are possible, that is centimeters, millimeters. Distance can be measured in anything, but broadly we are going to use these two units, that is kilometers and meters. So these are the units of distance, right? Now next I have the time, that units for time measurement will be given in seconds, as we know, or we can take it in hours, otherwise we can take it in minutes, and so on, right? So all these are units for the measurement of speed. That means speed and time and distance all have their different units separately for individual one. So we have the three basic topics of the chapter, that is the speed, time and distance. Speed is actually distance traveled or the distance covered by object in unit time. This is measured in kilometers per hour or meters per second. We have the speed formula derived as per the definition, that will be distance traveled upon time taken. If the distance is in kilometers and time is in hours, the unit for the speed would be kilometer per hour. If the distance is in meters and time is in seconds, the unit for speed is meter per second. While we are doing the formula for distance, we have distance is equal to speed into time, where speed can be in kilometers per hour. If the speed is in kilometer per hour and time has to be in hour, because the units have to be same. So both are having the time units as hours and the distance unit in speed was kilometer. So the distance will be measured in kilometers. If the speed is given in meters per second and time is in seconds, then the distance will be measured in meters. Now for the time, time is equal to distance upon speed. If your distance is in meters and time and your speed is in meters per second, your time will be measured in seconds. But if your distance is in kilometers and your speed is in kilometers per hour, your time will come as per the hour units. Similarly, you can have so many other units depending on the question, in that the question is given in which type of unit. Depending on that, we can convert the units and we can give the answer.